We're very excited to announce the release of Oxygen 27. This video will present some highlights of new features and updates that were added in this version. A myriad of new features were implemented for the AI Positron Assistant, which is an extra add-on that can be installed to provide AI assistance. It now leverages a retrieval-augmented generation process to use information gathered from your project to make the AI's response more relevant. In this example, we have an XML file with some basic instructions for creating a new draft. After we click the Generate Documentation Draft button, the AI retrieves information from the project to generate a proposal for a draft. We'll click the Generate Document from Response button, and the AI creates a new document based on our instructions and information gathered from the project. Intelligent Agents is a new category of AI actions designed to streamline data topic management. The Expand Draft action enhances a data topic by using information gathered from related links and the current project via the retrieval augmented generation process mentioned earlier. We can preview the proposed changes before applying them. For our example of a fictitious interface mode, some minor cleanup will be required, but it refined and expanded the topic to be similar to topics from our project about other similar interface modes. Also in the Intelligent Agents category, the Split Topic action can be used to split large data topics with numerous subjects into multiple topic files. You can see that the AI generated several new topics, and it modified the original file as well. Another intelligent agent, the Create Topics action, generates data topics based on user input. We provided some simple instructions. It also retrieves relevant project content to shape the response. The AI requests approval and will confirm to continue the processing. And it generated several topics based on our instructions and data retrieved from our project. Some new AI actions were also added for reusing data content. For example, we'll find and select a note that we think might already have an existing reusable component defined in our project. We'll use the Reuse Component AI action. And the AI found a similar reused component and proposes to replace the note with the reusable component. Another example in the reuse category is the product name action. It searches for product names in the content, and then the AI looks for keys defined for the specific product names and replaces them with key references. The Positron is now able to detect blocks of XML code within the AI response. We'll select the table in our sample document, and we'll give the AI instructions to convert the table into a definition list. Notice that the AI's response contains XML markers surrounding XML code. And we'll preview it to show that the Positron is able to detect and insert the XML code. Some new development AI actions were also implemented. For example, we'll use the Generate Code button to have the AI propose code based on the instructions specified in our XSLT document. Another development example, the Suggest Refactoring action, generates a suggestion for refactoring the selected code to simplify it or make it easier to read and understand. The diff tool also received some enhancements. Within the directories comparison tool, you can click the settings button, go to files comparison, and there's an option there to ignore nodes by XPath. We'll have it ignore the ID attribute of the concept element. And after re-performing the comparison, you see that it now detects fewer differences since it ignored the nodes we specified. The Quick Fix support is now automated through the Apply All Default Quick Fix Proposals tool, making it possible to apply all proposed quick fixes in one or more resources at once. There are numerous ways to invoke the tool. we're invoking it from the DataMaps manager in this example. In most cases, you can choose a scope, current DataMap hierarchy in this instance, and it applies quick fix proposals for all reported validation errors in the specified scope. The built-in Saxon processor used for XSLT and XQuery transformations and debugging has been updated to version 12.5. The new 12.5 engines are available to choose from, and we'll invoke the content completion in the XSLT file to show you that it includes the latest extension functions. An enhanced feature was added that enables you to transform JSON documents using XQuery processing. You see that there is a new JSON transformation with XQuery scenario type. We'll select our XSLT file and apply the transformation. And in this case, it produced XML content in the results pane. The XQuery Builder view also now supports running XQuery over JSON documents. Notice there are three new JSON 12.5 engines specifically for JSON. The Builder view allows you to compose complex XQuery expressions and execute them over the currently edited document. And you can see that it produced XML output in the results view. These were just a handful of examples of the new features and enhancements that were implemented in Oxygen 27. For a complete list of all the additions, see our What's New page on our website.